Okay, this is the rant video two. I have already solved part A of this question, and we found the acceleration of the ball to be -4.5 meters per second squared. Now, if you didn't set it up how I did and assign down as being negative and up as being positive, you may have come out with an acceleration, a positive acceleration of 4.5 meters per second squared. Which is okay as long as we understand that's going down the ramp. 4.5 meters per second is positive. It means that you'd still have to indicate that it's down the ramp. It's got an acceleration of 4.5 meters per second squared down the ramp. That's the acceleration down the ramp. So I guess my point here is that it doesn't have to necessarily be that to be correct, depending on how you solved or set up the problem. Now we want to go back to the problem, and we have a second step here, and that is to find the velocity of the ball at another time period. So if I go here and copy and paste that guy, now I want to find what is the velocity there. At the beginning, it has a velocity, initial velocity, we said to be 0 meters per second because it was released. It had no velocity. But we also know that it's going to gain velocity as it rolls down the hill. So down here will be the max velocity in terms of this story anyway. We haven't changed our 36-meter ramp, so it's still 36 meters long. And we also know that the time to get down the ramp is 4 seconds. So let's start our variables list. We know time is 4 seconds. We know our initial velocity to be 0 meters per second. We're looking for our final velocity. We don't know what that is. And we know the acceleration now because we've solved it in that problem and we said it was -4.5 meters per second squared. And finally, we know our displacement to be -36 meters. Now, I also should tell you or indicate that there's more than one way to get to this answer. You could do it in one step, one equation, or multiple steps, depending on how you want to break the problem down and solve it. I'm going to just do it in one way. I'm going to find the velocity of the ball at the bottom of the ramp using an equation that has those variables in it. So if I look at my variable list, since I'm looking for the final velocity, seems like the easiest one for me to use is Vf squared, that's the final velocity squared, equals the initial velocity squared, right, plus 2a delta x, or 2 times a times the displacement. So that's the equation we're going to use, and it's all set up, ready to go. So let me move this. Velocity here, the final velocity, is what we're solving for. All right, so let's just plug in those numbers. Vf squared equals the initial velocity squared, which is 0 meters per second squared, plus 2 times the acceleration, which is -4.5 meters per second squared, times the displacement, which is -36 meters. Now I'm going to skip and kind of go underneath here. I'm also going to change the color of that to blue so it doesn't get all mixed in there, because that's what we're looking for, the velocity at that point. So I'm going back to my red crayon here, and I say that the final velocity squared is equal to, well, 0 squared is 0, so we don't even need that. And then we're going to go 2 times 4.5, so it's 0, right, plus 2 times -4.5 meters per second squared times -36 meters, just to keep that straight. And when we do that, we say that the final velocity squared is equal to 324, and that's 324 meters squared divided by second squared, if you're keeping track of the units. But remember, as long as we have good units going in, we're going to get good units coming out. So now we just simply take the square root of this and the square root of this, and we're all set. And the final answer is 18 meters per second. When I took the square root, that took care of those two things. And that's the unit we want, 18 meters per second. So it is going at the bottom of the ramp, 18 meters per second. Okay, and that, oh, sorry. And that's negative or down the ramp. Something that we're going to have to apply because of doing the square root. You're going to have an understanding that that velocity is negative. It's gaining that velocity. But if you just simply said 18 meters per second down the ramp, that works for me too. Okay. Now, I'm going to point something out here. I'm going to go and add a slide here. Insert a blank page. And if we go back, and I'm going to copy this. And I'm going to paste it here. All right, if we look at that, what the acceleration means, full screen. If we look at what the acceleration means, if we talk about where it is at particular times down the ramp, we were talking about 4 seconds, right? If this was 0 seconds, 1 second, 2 seconds, 3 seconds, 4 seconds down the ramp, it should make sense to us if it started at 0 meters per second. Our velocity, so that's our time. Now our velocity here is 0. Our velocity here is negative 4.5 meters per second because of the acceleration. It gained 4.5 meters per second downward every second. So when we go from here to here, we have now negative 9 meters per second. That's how fast it's going at 2 seconds. And we on down to the 3-second mark, we are going, 13.5 meters per second, and add on another 4.5. When we get to here, we are now at, and that's negative 2, we are now at negative 18 meters per second. So adding on 4.5 each second gets me to 18 meters per second after 4 seconds. So that should make sense to me. All right, so that's the final velocity. Thinking it through, after solving it in this form.